Have you ever heard someone say, "The way things are is the way they've always been"? As we learned from regression, the best predictor of future behavior is past behavior. So now we are going to learn a non-parametric test that will tell us whether the way things are is a good fit to the way we expect them to be. The chi-square goodness of fit tests whether sample data are a good fit to a comparison population. Do the new data match what is known about an existing distribution? Because we will be comparing known values, we will multiply n by each of the known percentages to get each expected value. Let me illustrate. Suppose you know that 60% of Missouri residents favor outlawing puppy mills, 35% oppose the policy, and 5% are undecided. You want to compare opinions in Arkansas and Iowa. Missouri is our known value, our comparison population. In this case, the expected values would be 60%, 35%, and 5%, respectively. When we survey the people in Arkansas, we find that 58% favor, 36% oppose, and 6% are undecided. Is this a good fit to our comparison population? Yes, it is. It is not a perfect fit, but it's a good fit. Then we repeat our survey in Iowa. This time, we find that 42% favor, 54% oppose, and 4% are undecided. Is this a good fit to our comparison population? No, it is not. This time, the observed distribution differs from our comparison population. It is not a good fit. Now, the way that we are going to determine expected values is to look at the percentages in our comparison population and apply those percentages to the observed distribution. We will see if the percentages are a good fit. To get the expected values, multiply each of the population percentages by the total n of your observed values. And I've got a bloody good chi-square to illustrate this chi-square goodness of fit test, where we assume no difference from the comparison population. It is known that blood type varies among different populations of people. In the United States, types O, A, B, and AB make up 45%, 40%, 10%, and 5% of the population, respectively. Suppose the blood types are collected for a sample of 140 people from a foreign country. The raw numbers were 42, 64, 20, and 14. Is there a significant difference between this distribution and what we would expect based on distributions in the USA? We will begin with the five steps of hypothesis testing. Step number one, select the appropriate statistic. We are comparing proportions from an obtained sample to what we expect to find based on the distribution in a comparison population. So, we will use the one-way chi-square goodness of fit test for a no-difference situation. Step two, state the null and alternative hypotheses. Now, in this case, the percentages of obtained values are being compared to an assumption that there is no difference from the percentages in the comparison population. The distribution of blood types should be the same in the foreign country as it is in the United States. So the null hypothesis is H sub zero, blood type distribution in the foreign country fits the U.S. distribution, or is the same as the distribution in the U.S. The alternative hypothesis is H sub one, blood type distribution in the foreign country does not fit the U.S. distribution. Now, if you were doing a different chi-square, you might adjust these hypotheses to match your particular variables. Step three, select the level of significance. As with all of our previous research, we will assume the value is alpha equals 0.05 two-tailed test. except that all chi-square tests are one-tailed, so we'll just skip that. The degrees of freedom equals k minus 1, where k is the number of categories in your sample. So we have 4 blood types, so the degrees of freedom is 3. To find the critical value, we will go to the chi-square table, which is available at the end of your notes. For an alpha level of 0.05 with 3 degrees of freedom, the critical value is 7.81. Chi-square values greater than 7.81 indicated that the observed values are not a good fit to the expected values. Step 4. Calculate the statistics. Let's begin with the formula for chi-square. We are going to use this formula for each blood type, so we will use it 4 times. Doing a chi-square by hand is easiest if we make a table of the data. We need 5 columns, which I will number 1 through 5, and this will help us apply the formula each time that we use it. We will begin with the observed values, the raw numbers from the foreign country for each blood type, which we will put in the O column, O for observed. And now we need the expected values. We have 140 people, and we have the percentages from the U.S. comparison population. We will determine the expected values by multiplying each percentage by the total 140. This will give us the numbers that would be expected if the percentages in the comparison population matched what we observed. Good news! All of our expected values are greater than 5. Now, obviously, these expected values differ from the observed values, but do they differ statistically significantly? To find out, we will subtract each expected value from its respective observed value, O minus E. That is column 3. Now, this is also a good time to do a data check. The O minus E column should always add up to 0. Now, this makes sense because the O values add up to N, the total sample size, and the E values also add up to N, the total sample size. So we are subtracting N from N, and the total, therefore, should be 0. Next, we square each value in column 3, and that gives us the 4th column. For the 5th column, we will divide each value in the 4th column by its respective expected value. Now, for this test, all of the expected values are different, so we divide each of the 4th column values by the expected values from that row. Now, the last step is to add up the 5th column. Those values add up to 17.71. So let's go back to our 5 steps of hypothesis testing. Step number 4, calculate the statistics. The total chi-square value was 17.71. And step 5, make the decision. Compare the obtained chi-square value, 17.71, to the critical value, 7.81. Since the chi-squared value exceeds or is further from 0 than the critical value, the results are statistically significant. The distribution of blood types is not the same as in the United States. Chi-square with 3 degrees of freedom, N of 140, equals 17.71, p less than 0.05. And here is a sample APA write-up for our one-way chi-square goodness of fit test. A chi-square goodness of fit test was conducted to determine if the distribution of blood types in a foreign country is the same as in the United States. Expected frequencies in all cells were greater than 5. There was a statistically significant difference in distribution. The distribution of blood types is not the same as in the U.S. Chi-square, 3 degrees of freedom, N of 140 equals 17.71, p less than 0.05.